So today's video, I'm sharing with you my 5 steps for getting for sale by owners to list with you. So I was asked in the comment section of one of my videos to share with you guys my follow-up plan of how I follow up with for sale by owners. And so I sat down this morning and I started just writing out step by step, like, what do I do? What is my follow-up plan when it comes to following up with for sale by owners? And I ended up just writing out my entire process and putting it into 5 steps of what I do from the very first time you meet the for sale by owner until you list them. So start to finish, I've never written it down like formally, but I started using this plan. This is what I've done my entire time that I've been in the business. The very beginning, I got a vast majority of my business came from using this plan. And I still get a lot of business from using this. And I came up with this plan through a lot of trial and error and kind of just seeing what other people are doing, what's working for them, and then taking bits and pieces of that and then putting my own spin on it. So super simple way to get for sale by owners to list with you. This is pretty much what I do every single time. So step number one is the initial contact. And what that means is basically just getting your face in front of their face somehow, some way. And there are many different ways that you can do this. I have a couple methods that I talk about quite a bit on my channel. One of those is the for sale by owner preview appointment, which I'll link any videos I have relating to that down below. And then the other method that I talk about is just driving directly to the for sale by owner's house, knocking on their door and introducing yourself. So what I've found from personal experience through lots of trial and error is that it doesn't necessarily matter which method you're using, whether you're meeting them through the preview appointment method or you're just driving to their house. It does not necessarily matter. One way is it always better than the other way. It's just get in front of them somehow, some way, get face to face with the seller. And like I always say, every seller is different. Every situation that the sellers are in is different. So sometimes I will be calling a for sale by owner and planning on using the for sale by owner preview script on them and then end up going a completely different route because everyone's different. You just have to feel out the situation. So that's my first step. And the goal of that is just meet face to face. So step number two is write a handwritten thank you note. And the goal of that is to separate yourself from the competition. Step number three is send a for sale by owner presentation directly to their door. And what I put in my for sale by owner presentation that I've created, I make it look very professional and nice and put together. And I just basically give them a lot of information about reasons why they should list with a realtor. But not only that, I also give them tips for selling their home, tips for getting their home ready to sell, information about myself, my company, that type of thing. And I send it to their door, directly to their door, right after I talk to them. I get that sent to their door, one day delivery. And then I call them and let them know that I sent them helpful information on the home selling process and ask them to review it when possible. And the goal of that is basically just to show them that you are the obvious agent to list with if they do decide to list. Number four is follow up. And what this looks like is sending them mail once a week, and don't overthink it. Just get something in the mail that has your face, your contact information, your branding on it every single week. Don't overthink or stress over what it is that you're sending, whether it's market stats. I mean, it doesn't really matter. I send them a lot of things that are helpful to them that I think they might find helpful, like tips for buying and selling a home at the same time, basically just to show them that I am a local resource and I do have that knowledge, because obviously they want that in a realtor, but don't stress about it. Just send them something in the mail once a week. I'm also going to be calling the for sale by owner once a week or so to check in. So, that's my fourth step. And then my fifth and final step is wait to get the listing. And the reason that I said that as my fifth step is because I think a lot of people give up way too quickly when it comes to for sale by owners. Sometimes you will get the listing on step one or step two or step three or four, but most of the time, like the high majority of the time, you're not gonna get the listing until step five or after. And so just really be patient is huge, and just continue to follow up. So there you have it. That is my 5-step plan that I follow. If any of you guys try this, I would love to hear your results and hear if it's been working for you guys and how it's been working. If you are a realtor and you live in another state and you have a client relocating to Oregon, send them my way. I would love to give you a referral fee. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video.